So as now you can see that this is a symmetrical alkene, so plus and minus charge does not have a very much important factor over here. But if I now talk about a unsymmetrical alkene, what it would be? Unsymmetrical alkene means, suppose I have taken 3 carbon atoms. So if I am reacting this with a halogen, what it would have happened? It can form 2 things. It is having a hydrogen, this one hydrogen, 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 and this one is having a hydrogen and hydrogen. So it can form 2 things. The double bond breaks immediately. It is having CH2, one H is over here. Now see what will happen. The according to Markovnikov's rule, the carbon atom which is having less number of hydrogen atom, between these 2 carbon atoms we can see that this carbon is having lesser hydrogen atom. So what happens? The halogen will be coming and it will be getting attached over here, and this will be having a minus charge. So the hydrogen comes over here and gets attached. Another compound can also form over here by the help of anti-Markovnikov's rule. What you can see that this carbon which was having a plus charge due to the deficiency of hydrogen, and this one which was having a negative charge due to more a number of hydrogen atoms, what happens this time? Just the opposite thing. The halogen will be coming over here and it will be, the hydrogen will be coming over here and it will be getting attached to the carbon atom which is having a plus charge, and the halogen atom will be going to that carbon atom which is having a negative charge, that is greater number of hydrogen atoms. If you remember very carefully, this is having a plus charge over here and this is having a plus charge, this carbon atom is having a plus charge over here. According to anti-Markovnikov's rule, just the opposite thing. The carbon atom which is having more number of hydrogen atoms will be having a